done.
Thank you. Good morning, Reverend Brothers, Mr. Brennan, invited guests, staff, men of saints, and families and friends remotely viewing from home. So welcome to our final assembly for 2021. Today we will recognise the talents and achievements of our students, and Mr. Seavers will also farewell a number of our staff members. So please stand as we welcome our official party.
To invite Sterling Harris and Kevin Tittersey to deliver our acknowledgement of country and opening prayer.
As Indigenous and non-Indigenous people gathering today, let us have a sense of the importance of the country upon which this celebration is being held, where learning and ceremony have taken place over many thousands of years. Let us sense the land beneath our feet and acknowledge to whom it belongs, the Gimwe, Wallabara, Yidinji, and Yiriganji people. Let us pay our respect to their elders and all elders, past, present, and future. For we too are one in land, one in spirit, one in faith, united in God's love.
Please join me in the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord God, thank you for the year we call 2021, a year of service, sporting, and academic achievements. We thank you for the ability to battle times of difficulty, the ability to come together as a saints family, and the ability to exceed in all aspects of college life. We thank you for your guidance and unconditional love. We do this in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. St. Marcelin Champagne.
Pray for us.
Mary, our good mother.
Pray for us.
And let us always remember.
Pray.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Kevin and Sterling. I'd now like to invite Sterling again to present our service awards for 2021.
Every year at Saints, we really dig deep when it comes to service. In this last term, the Year 11s have really stepped up with Rosies. A big thanks to all the boys who have helped out. We had a lot of great feedback come back about your positive actions. As well as this, the Vinnie's Christmas Hampers appeal has been a hit, with a total of 70 hampers being donated. When we look at the flyer, it's like the loaves and the fishes story in the Bible. We brought in goods to feed the needy and share what we have. That is really well done, boys. It will make a huge difference to local families struggling on Christmas Day. On another service note, there are no confirmed dates or times for the hamper packing, but if you're interested, can you send an email to Mrs. Cross or check the newsletter which has the Vinnie's contact person details. There is also another opportunity for interested students to assist our administration manager in coordinating the Adopt-A-Family Christmas project. Once again, email Mrs. Cross for more details or check the newsletter. A really solid effort, boys. Be proud of how well we've done. Can't wait to see what we can do for the community next year. We would like to invite Mr. Gates and Mr. Carboni to come forward and accept these hampers.
Good morning, everyone. It's a pleasure to be back here. I spoke briefly to many of you a week or two ago, and you've done yourselves proud with so many types of foods and so on brought in. As Sterling said, you've made a big difference to a lot of people this year with Rosie's, with this and various other things. I spoke last time about making a difference, how you, one person, can make a difference, and you can see that there is a big difference going to be made here to the lives of people in Cairns. We often get discouraged by thinking that we can't actually solve any of these problems, and it's true. By ourselves, we can't. It's too big. But we can make a difference to the people that we meet, and I think that is a good thing for us to do. Whoever we meet, that we make a difference in their lives. So hopefully you'll take that away with you from Saints when you leave here, as your Year 12s have done this year. And also, you'll practice that now. In doing that, you truly will be men of Saints. So this morning, we're accepting these things, which will be packed later into the truck and then put into hampers. If anyone wants to volunteer, you already heard Sterling explain how you can do that. But we'd also like to say thanks very much in a more tangible form. And Con Carboni, our president, has something that he'd like to present to the college. So thank you very much on behalf of Sir Vincent de Paul.
And now for the service awards. For a bronze service awards, Nicholas Jensen. John Pico. Jake Sullivan. Caleb Howard. Andrew Robinson. Daniel Ibinger. Axel Bohr. Luke Spence. Anthony Yellow. Massimo Palapiano. Joel Vincent. Mark Clark. And Ethan Holden. Now for the silver awards, Graham O'Donna, Archibald Reed, Lincoln O'Hara, Noah Wright, Max Poglio, Harry Reardon, Harrison Follent, Jaden Cox, Harrison McAvoy, Andre Arloy. Aidan Cridlin. Hudson Parker. Harrison Massingham. Ross Hunter. And Oliver Davey. Now for the Gold Awards. Talbot McFarlane. Brandon Futura. Cooper Campbell. Maximus McKinley. Ian Medrano. Mark Allam. Jack Brunetto. Benjamin Sinclair. Ryan Jones. Bryn Swain. Thomas Barber. Hayden Pute. And Joe Rauter. And for our two Platinum Awards this year, Darcy Oates. And Dan Formiati. Let's give these boys a hand. Our next six awards are for technical service, which is for helping up in the booth up the top and stuff like that. So, Jaron Dijon. Oliver Jones. And Finn Slade. The next three boys have been helping with everything tech related up in the booth up the back for the past 3 years. Next year they are going to focus on their studies a bit more, but we really appreciate all the work you've done. The awards go to Matthew Christensen, Michael Doolin, and Harrison Massingham.
Thank you, Sterling, and great job to all the boys who received their service awards. I would now like to invite Noah Conlon to the stage to deliver our Movember report for this year.
Good morning, Mr. Brennan, staff and men of Saints. In 2003, two mates, Travis Garone and Luke Slattery, met up in a gypsy bar in Fitzroy, Victoria. They joked that the moustache had recently gone out of fashion and was nowhere to be seen in recent years. They wanted to bring it back. Now, one of their mutual friend's mothers happened to be doing fundraising for breast cancer at this point in time. And while they were more than supportive of her cause, they soon realised that men's physical and mental health was an often neglected topic of conversation in Australian media. And it is a big topic. Every year, 4,000 to 5,000 men die from testicular and prostate cancer in Australia alone, and the same number of Australian men will commit suicide. And yet, in 2003, you'd have been lucky to hear about these staggering numbers in Australian media. So, these two mates invited their friends to use their mows to bring attention to the issues at hand. And from two mates to 2003, to 30, to 480 in 2004, to 10,000 in 2005, to over 6 million last year in 2020, Movember has been responsible for over 1,250 projects related to men's physical and mental health, with funds being pushed towards creating a world where the premature loss of men's lives is reduced by 25%. Here at Saints, our teachers have taken up the challenge to grow their own mows and dedicate funds to the cause. From Mr. Elliott's glorious pencil stash to Mr. Brennan's zapper, in addition to cheating allegations towards certain members of staff who took it upon themselves to begin growing their mows before the dedicated date of November 1st. This year's Movember turnout has been a record breaker, and yesterday our students were given the difficult task of voting upon the most impressive mow in town. I'd like to give a big shout out to the teachers who have raised a combined $3,000 independently towards Movember, and to the boys who have been donating to the cause. Combined, we've been able to raise over $3,500. It's even more impressive considering that we were able to raise these funds at the same time as the Vinnie's Appeal. Great job to everyone involved. Now, I've been asked to announce the winners, the top three winners of the Movember competition. However, I must note that first and second place are currently absent at a men's mental health conference. And so I won't be inviting anyone come up the stage to collect their awards. We'll be doing that tomorrow. So, let me just get it out. In third place, Mr. Williams. Mr. Williams will be receiving a bottle of Gillette shaving cream. Don't know what he's going to do with that. Coming in second, receiving a packet of eco-friendly razors and Gillette shaving cream, Mr. Tamakio. Now what we've all been waiting for, coming in first place, who will be receiving a bottle of Gillette shaving cream and a chic razor, Mr. James. Thank you to all your contributions, boys, and congratulations to all the staff involved.
Thank you, Noah. I would now like to invite Saxon Karpalos to deliver his arts report.
Good morning, Mr. Brennan, brothers, invited guests, staff, and men of Saints. O fortune, like the moon, you are changeable, ever waxing, ever waning. Hateful life first oppresses and then soothes as fancy takes it. Poverty and power, it melts them like ice. These are the words to the opening movement of Carmina Burana, O Fortuna, Latin for O Fortune. After months of heavy planning, St. Augustine's and St. Monica's are proud to present one of the most renowned works of music, Carl Orff's Carmina Burana. This performance is going to be held at the Cairns Performing Arts Centre on the 28th of April next year, hopefully with the help of musicians from Redeemer Lutheran College in Brisbane and other schools around Cairns. So tell your friends, tell your family, tell your neighbours about this performance because this is going to be one showstopper overnight. For any budding musicians or anyone for that matter that wants to be involved with such a big project, please email Ms. Spannenberg for further information and to show your interest because we're going to need all the help we can get. In addition to this, a heads up that the combined Colleges Saints Youth Theatre production is going to go ahead next year in Term 3. At this stage, it is not decided what the play is going to be yet. Even though this is far ahead into the future, it is something that enthusiastic thespians should keep in the back of their mind. With the Saints Youth Theatre, no formal theatre or drama experience is required. It's all about having a dig and getting out of your comfort zone. So make sure to keep your eyes peeled later next year. Finally, last Thursday was the orientation day and evening for the promising Year 6 students arriving to St. Augustine's next year. For the evening talk, Ryan Cartwright, Regan Crooks, and Nick Taflos performed for the Year 6s to give them a taste of the arts here at Saints. It was a valiant effort, especially as none of the gents are playing the main instrument. Now sit back and relax as the trio are going to perform Better Be Home Soon by Crowded House.
Thank you, Saxon, and thank you, boys, for that phenomenal performance. I'd now like to invite Jack Burdett to deliver our academic awards for Semester 2, 2021.
Earlier this year, our top maths classes participated in the Australian Maths Competition, putting the mathematical fluency to the test. Today we are recognising a high level of aptitude displayed by a number of students who have achieved a result which awarded them either a distinction or high distinction. A distinction certificate is awarded to a student who is in the top 20% of their year and region, and a high distinction for students who reached the top 3%. These students are as follows. For Year 7, Kyle Hiranuma. Jake Sullivan. Daniel Yanez. For Year 8, Caden Marino. Leo Riccardi. Oliver Wilson. For Year 9, Benjamin Field. Ryan Jones. Yuta Ma. And Alex McCurdy. For Year 10, Andre Aloy. Matthew Filipponi. Futa Ma. Troy McNeil. Chaz Nelda. Riley O'Sullivan. Kano Thompson. And Gabriel Weeks. For Year 11, Tristan Obleitner. Oliver Davey. Connor Deng. Jack Hardy. And Jackson Ma. A special congratulations goes to Bryn Swain, being the only student to achieve a high distinction, his result placing him in the top 3% of students nationally. Following this are five students who have been awarded an award from JCU. These awards recognize outstanding students from year 7 to year 12. The winning students exhibit all or some of the following. Exhibits the greatest academic achievement or progress in their studies. Exemplifies a commitment to building the economic and social fabric of their community, especially in regard to regional Australia. And demonstrates resilience and perseverance in their studies or extracurricular accomplishments. $100 bursaries are also generously provided by JCU. These boys are as follows. In year 7, Archibald Reed. For year 8, Owen Downey. For year 9, Bryn Swain. For year 10, Chaz Nelda. And for year 11, myself. Congratulations to these five boys. The University of Queensland School for Economics competition took place in semester 2 for year 11 and year 12 economics students. The competition is coordinated by the Queensland Economics Teachers Association and sponsored by the University of Queensland School of Economics. The competition consists of 40 multiple choice questions assessing content from the economics senior syllabus. A number of our students demonstrated a strong understanding of economics and the importance it has for business and government. We recognise the efforts of five of our students today. I ask Mr. Brennan to present these certificates. Please keep your applause to the end. With a high distinction, Jack Hardy. A credit awarded to Elliot Bairstow. Riley Jackson. Joel Thomas. And Jacob Watson. Please congratulate these boys on their achievements. Finally, a special award is given to Owen Downey, who has achieved first prize in a science report competition. Congratulations, Owen.
Thank you, Jack, and congratulations to all the boys who received those certificates. I'd now like to invite the peer support class of 2021 to stand. And could I also invite the five current Year 7 students to deliver their report on their peer supports: Xavier Ellis, Nicholas Minrod, Hayden Coombs, Luke Reinhardt, and Taj Ashby.
We have looked forward to seeing our peer support boys each Friday, when they come to give us the advice, play games with us, and have helped us get used to Saints in our first year. They have been strong role models and great friends. Thank you, Tristan L. Blightner. Riley Jackson. Noah Conlon. Banjo Robinson. Zayden Tanner. And Martin Weiss.
Thanks to our Year 11 peer support buddies for giving up their time and mentoring us through the year. We appreciate you and the assistance with assessments and helping us feel relaxed around the school. Thanks for the Freddos and the year. Thank you to William Brett, Jack Burdett, Saxon Kapilos, Jesse Nelson, Massimo Palapiano, and Oscar Regina.
The Year 11 peer support team have helped us considerably through the year, from sorting out our lockers and diaries, showing us around the school, and pointing us in the right direction when we have been lost. They got us prepared for events like camp, walkathon, and sports carnivals, and told us what to expect. But most of all, they have been a friendly face to say hi to as we walk around the college. They have been there every week to ask us how we are doing and make sure that we are coping academically and socially. Thank you for being our friends and supporting us through our first year at Saints. Thank you, Jack Hardy. Sterling Harris. Dane Margiotta. Connor Puri. Joe Router. And Sydney Whip.
Words to describe the Year 11 Peer Support Buddies: encouraging, comforting, selfless, supportive, wise, helpful, dependable, epic, cool. The Year 11s have encouraged, supported, and empowered us to be Saints men. They inspire, they are selfless, they are brothers. Thank you, Connor Deng. James Harrop. Hossein Napiri. Hayden Pute. Kevin Tatasi. And Joel Vincent.
On behalf of the 7.5 homeroom, we thank you all for all you have done for us on Friday mornings. We thank you for modelling how we should act at Saints and showing us how we should aspire to be peer support mentors in 4 years. So Bailey, Will, Zach, Kaylin, Mitchell and Owen, please work on your jokes so that Monday morning parades look funnier than your Friday efforts. Thank you, Zach Downey. Owen Dunn. Caleb Maher. And Mitchell Skirpa.
Thank you to my fellow peer support students and the Year 7 boys. It has been a great year. A special thanks to you five blokes who got up and spoke today. I know it takes some guts and courage to stand up here in front of your whole group. I'd now like to welcome Joe Router, our sports captain, to deliver the sports report and sports awards for this year.
Good morning, staff, students, and Mr. Brennan. This year has been one of many excellent sporting achievements for the school, which is going to be hard to follow up next year. The JSS teams this year may not have won at all, but they were five great teams full of some great athletes. These teams didn't manage to win any grand finals, but still came in at second overall, which is a commendable achievement. So good job, boys. And it's highlighted by the performances of our outstanding athletes. For AFL, the MVP is Will Munro. The most improved, Isaac Lucan. And and Coach's Award, Jai Lohman. For basketball, MVP, Leo Riccardi. Most improved, Mitchell Hurst. And Coach's Award, William Imhoff. For football, MVP, Kalen Niesler. Most improved, Michael Ward. And Coach's Award, Ryan Taddy. For touch, the MVP was Charlie Bird. Most improved was Jack Ricks. And Coach's Award, Harry Reardon. For volleyball, the MVP was Evan Ung. Most improved, Ethan Herney. And Coach's Award, Aiden Prestipino. Give these boys a round of applause. Now please enjoy this video.
Feel
Thank you, Joe, and congratulations to all the boys who received their sports word awards. A special thank you also to Zen Hodges for putting together that video for us. I'd now like to invite Mr. Sievers and Mr. Brennan to farewell some of our staff from 2021.
Mr. Brennan, staff and students. This year, the college undertook an external review run by the Australian Council for Educational Research, ERASA. And boys, many of you would remember visitors sitting in your classes, interviewing your teachers. We were very happy with the results of the review. The concluding comment by Tony McGruther was that once a teacher or a student found a school like St. Augustine's, they should never leave. He said this to emphasise that this was a great school, and what is happening here is special, and if you can stay, you should. Obviously though, life takes us in different directions, but staff have certainly taken this comment on board, and today our farewells are few. I'd like to emphasise that we only have five staff leaving. Of those five who we farewell today, two are gap students who are on a regular one-year appointment. Most well-run organisations cater for 10 to 15% turnover of staff. The fact that St. Augustine's turnover is closer to 2% is a testament to the sense of belonging and family that is present at St. Augustine's. But life does take us on different paths, and change is healthy. For those staff that are leaving, we wish you the best, and may you take the Mara spirit and charism with you and continue with St. Marston's vision of making Jesus Christ known and loved. Before I farewell the staff, I'd just like to mention Mr. Chris Wright, who'll be taking long service leave for three terms next year. We look forward to having him back in term four. As I call forward the staff, can you please hold your applause until the end? Firstly, our gap students. Mr. Sam Cramp. As a gap student this year, Mr. Cramp has become a vital member of the college's boarding program. Students have benefited from his friendly, caring nature, and staff have appreciated his level of expertise in many areas. We may be seeing Mr. Cramp next year as he has been selected to play for the Northern Pride and is enrolled at university at JCU. Mr. Jake Quadling has completed the 12-month placement as a gap student as well. He has developed a wonderful rapport with the boarders through his friendly and easygoing demeanour. He's highly reliable and always went well above and beyond. Mr. Quadling is heading home to Cooma to work in the family plumbing business. Mrs. Claire Vant. Throughout 2021, Mrs. Vant fulfilled the crucial role of head of girls boarding. She developed many meaningful relationships with the girls in her care. Mrs. Vant facilitated the opening of a second girls' residence, and a calm disposition and a willingness to do whatever was required for the young people in her care has been evident. Mrs. Vant decided that with her two youngest children beginning school next year, that the time is right for a change from boarding. She will remain in Cairns and has accepted the position as head of PE at St. Monica's. Mrs. Jean Lendon. Mrs. Lendon has been an integral member of the college's front office since 2008. Her knowledge of processes and IT programs ensured an efficient and smooth running administration area for well over a decade. Mrs. Lendon has a love and passion not only for her role, but for the Maris charism of St. Augustine's. We thank Mrs. Lendon for her valued contribution to Saints and wish her all the best in her new role at Newman College. There is one more farewell, but I'll ask Mr. Brennan to farewell Mr. Johnson shortly. But can you show your appreciation, please, for Mrs. Lendon, Mrs. Vant, Mr. Quadling, Mr. Brown.
Good morning to Reverend Brothers, to staff, to students of the college and to those watching the live stream. It gives me great pleasure to farewell, well not pleasure, but it's my honour to farewell Mr. Johnson this morning. But before I do, there's a few words from some well-known people to many of the staff and to some of our students.
Hi everyone. I'm delighted to be part of this celebration, this farewell today. Albeit virtually, but such an important moment in the life of St. Augustine's, and of course in your life, Stan. 37 years, my goodness, that's a long time. So much has transpired, so much has changed in that time. to go back to the early or mid-80s is really go back to the BC era, to the before computers time. And the world has been transformed since then. We've had a digital revolution. So much has changed in school and education, in the way we teach, in the way we assess, the way we report. Even the name of your subject area standards, I think, had a few iterations in that time. And St. Augustine's itself has changed in curriculum. Remember the old CTC, so important in its time, but it's evolved. And so much of St. Augustine's also has evolved in its character and its style and its priorities to suit changing times and changing demands, and all that's healthy and good, and you've gone with that and embraced that. But through all of that change, Stan, I think you've been a rock. You've been a rock of stability, a rock of common sense, a rock of wisdom, a rock of groundedness. And if I can use a Marist word, a real rock of simplicity, the best sense of that word as we Marists use it. And to the extent that you've contributed and influenced St. Augustine's to be a more simple place in its culture and its ways, you've made it a more Marist school. So on behalf of all the principals with whom you've worked, how many is it, 6, 7, 8, the hundreds of colleagues, the thousands of students you've taught, thank you. And if I can employ the words of Jesus in the gospel, well done, good and faithful servant. You'll always be part of the Saints family, you'll always be part of the Marist family. But as you take steps into this next stage of your life's journey, I wish you and your family all the very best.
Morning, everyone. It's great to be with you today to celebrate Stan Johnson. What a wonderful contribution he's made to St. Augustine's and to Marist education. The thing that struck me about Stan when I was working with him was his quiet, down-to-earth manner. He was deeply caring about what he did. He was a hard worker, and he had a great passion for what he did, but he never sought the limelight. And so those qualities of simplicity, which we often speak about, and love of work came through very strongly in whatever Stan did. I was struck by the simple, down-to-earth, and supportive and affirmative type of relationships that he had with both staff and students. Thanks very much, Stan, for everything you've done, and I'm delighted to be here with you today and to wish you all the best for your retirement.
So we've heard there from Brother Michael Green. For those who didn't know, the first speaker, who was principal here for some time in the early part of this century, and then Brother Darren Burge, who was obviously the principal before I arrived. So as both gentlemen said, Mr. Johnson has dedicated 37 years to Catholic and Marist education here at St. Augustine's. Some facts though, of those 37 years, 35 of these has been head of the INTAD department. His longevity in the role is a testament to his ability to relate to students, staff and families in a collaborative and positive way. As we've heard from the two Marist brothers, Mr. Johnson embodies the Marist values, particularly of simplicity, presence and family spirit. He has a love of work, and he'll readily admit that he's always enjoyed coming to St. Augustine's. His ability to do good quietly has made Mr. Johnson an excellent role model for both students and his fellow workmates. Mr. Johnson's own personal values align with those of the school, a combination that has made him an influential leader here at Saints. As a member of the college's academic team, Mr. Johnson has been influential in shaping St. Augustine's approach to curriculum. He's led a department which has had a flexible, adaptable, and caters extremely well for the needs of the students. Mr. Johnson has waded his way successfully through the changes in curriculum that have occurred since the mid-80s. His commitment to staying abreast of current trends is admirable, and his resilience in moving towards the digital age is a testament to his perseverance and tenacity. Through his teaching career here at Saints, Mr. Johnson has always been heavily involved in co-curricular activities. He was secretary of the St Augustine's Rugby League Club, attended confraternity for 15 years, coached junior rugby league at Saints, including the second 13 and more recently the under 15s. Mr Johnson has also been significantly involved in outdoor ed and is a yearly participant on our Year 10 camp, which as we know is a full week in Chiligo. Mr Johnson leaves us this year, though he did intend to actually retire last year. The college needed someone to work as an assistant in INTAD and then to take a few classes. And it's been typical of Mr Johnson all of his time here, he postponed his retirement to help the school. I'm glad that his wife and some family are here to join us today, just to see what an impact Mr Johnson has had. I wish Mr Johnson a long and happy retirement to come. So it gives me great pleasure and a touch of sadness to invite Mr Johnson to come forward, accept a small gift and to address the college. Thanks, Mr Johnson.
Feeling emotional until that started, so bear with me. Thank you, Mr. Brennan, and thank you to the Marist principals for that video presentation. Greatly appreciated. I feel a little inadequate here amongst so much talent, and we witnessed that here today, and it's one of the reasons I love this place so much. So I can't leave here without thanking the people who have made the last 38 years so enjoyable. But before that, you've heard that I've been teaching here for 37 years, but you don't know that I began at a local state school here in Cairns in 1975. It means I've been teaching for 47 years, most of which I've enjoyed, but not all. Now, I was talking recently to my niece. She had just graduated from Year 12 in Mount Isa. And I asked her if she enjoyed school. Typically, her reply was no. She couldn't wait to get out of the place. So flippantly, I said to her that I enjoy school. I've been at mine for the last 37 years. Now, I thought about that statement later and remembered I started grade one at the age of five and have been attending school or some other learning institution ever since. That means I've been at school for 61 years. So I must really enjoy my schooling. It wasn't intentional, I can promise you that. I never in my wildest dreams, at your age, thought I would be a school teacher. It's just the way it worked out. So who do I want to thank for the last 38 years? Of course, it is you, the students of this college. You, your brothers, your cousins, in some cases your uncles, and even your fathers. I have wonderful memories of football trips all across the state, school camps to Chiligo, and creative workshop activities. All made possible because of the cooperation of the students. I come to work and am greeted with a good morning, good afternoon, thanked for the lesson, sometimes asked how was my day, and even told to have a good day. It's all powerful stuff in the lives of your teachers, so don't underestimate what that can do for them. I'm also proud to say that I've worked at St. Augustine's College, just as you too will one day be proud to say that you have attended this college. Will I miss this place? Of course I will. I will miss the interaction, but I also look forward to my retirement. Again, I thank you, and if you see me outside of here in later years, please say hello. And if I don't remember you, don't be upset or surprised or think I'm rude. It could be early dementia. So God bless you and goodbye.